All right, now.
Can I show you purses in the room?
Oh, look at this eucalyptus. I like that touch.
Oh, it smells so good.
Mighty
big one,
yes,
huh?
Nice.
Hello.
You
hope
good.
You like some flowers.
I do.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
somebody
else. Sorry.
Hello.
Okay. Hello.
Hi, Curtis.
All excited.
Uh-huh. Curtis is our photographer.
How do you do?
Good.
Dads and moms and everybody. And
hey, what's that? It's a toaster, rad.
I have to wrap it.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're falling behind schedule here.
But we certainly aren't the first people to give you your gift. Early.
Hi, how are you?
I hate rushing.
You're stressing? You were stressing?
The bride is doing very well.
No,
she's fine.
Oh, so her dress is so beautiful, babe.
She's in shock.
And you know, because it's set, it's like, oh, so sorry.
You guys did a penny thing,
huh? Oh!
I didn't get it. No.
No one's leaping up and saying, yes, I am.
Well, you know,
I'm
this way?
But see, you're at his house, so how much shopping can you do?
Because here's this. So,
I'm not
a sexy
either.
Okay.
Just a photographer.
Oh,
don't
I thought
where this goes.
Oh,
you have practice putting this on.
Mm-hmm.
This is Aiden.
Oh, here,
man.
Let's tuck those down, shall we? No.
We finally got the flowers we got. I'm feeling very good about it. I hope they stay.
Yes.
Yes. Look like you were born for this. You should get a job wearing a tux, not a car hop.
But something not with sunglasses hanging
on. No, is that little touch
will have to go.
I can work at a tux shop.
And wear one all the time. Guys in the tux shop wear shorts and jeans and have their hair down to their shoulders.
What? Dude.
All right.
I have to wear one of these?
The photographer, by the way, is excellent at doing this.
Did you see the hesitation?
Exactly where it goes.
Go get ready.
So you do makeup in this
room? No, I just did this for Amber. I do it for fun though. I love it.
It's for the vessel. Okay, I'm like, from the angle of the lighting, and I'm like,
oh, it's a big hole.
It did.
Well, I guess it really doesn't matter because we're going to end up in the hotel.
See that blue bag under there? And that other bag.
And you're going for a week?
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, we do the best we can. We clean up pretty nicely.
Okay. Joy?
Wasn't that a great time last night at the
hotel? Oh, that was so much fun.
We had so much fun.
Yeah. Oh, I'm Amber. Yeah?
She looks so beautiful. She's no, I'm telling you, it is incredibly surreal. It'll be that way the whole time. Well, you did a good job.
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to be good to you girls. So.
You learned from someone.
Yeah, have they taken pictures yet?
No,
we haven't even left yet.
Hey, Amber.
Thank you.
The two clothes.
So that was that rehearsal, dude. Bad.
All right.
I hope you got coverage on that.
I ran into two.
That was that rehearsal dinner.
Rehearsal dinner went well. That was tasty. How about you? Rehearsal dinner?
I'm not speaking.
I see.
He's going to show up in a second.
My attorney refuses to comment at this point.
Sophisticated, suave, debonair. That's Mass and Gavin.
If this looks unnatural, it is.
Felix, how'd you meet Amber?
What's that?
How'd you meet Amber?
We really want to go into that story? He dated her first. And then I met her at... I actually met her at a mass at Tina Johnson's house. Then both of us got rid of the whole youth group thing together and started hanging out together. It was a lot of fun. That was about 4 years ago.
So we're supposed to stand still.
Yeah, why are we standing still?
We're
standing with the video camera. Oh, yeah,
we're all ready.
Cheese. Yo, you look beautiful.
So who's the best man?
What's that? Yeah. Who's the best man?
Why is
this
that?
One?
Pardon
me?
Why is that?
Why is he the best man? No one else would do it?
yeah, we're on camera.
He's single.
Yeah, he's single, he's got the time.
No comments.
You gotta
edit yourself,
my friend. Yeah. Oh, Mr. GQ himself.
Go, Felix.
Yeah. I'll do that. Sophisticated look off to the right.
Chuck E. Cheese.
Don't go there. he does.
You guys are not helping at all.
The rest of the family.
You know, you've heard the song, the Bringing the Clowns. Yeah, here we are. I forgot my juggling balls. Darn. Yeah, my shoulder be all messed up.
Just hang it out in the middle of nowhere.
Glad this stick it out there.
Stick what out there?
Stick it out. I don't know. I wasn't there. Okay, jack it back on.
I'm going to go to sleep. I'm going to pull the sleeve. You got it?
Okay, where'd it go?
Short sleeve.
Wait a minute. That's a little too much, guys.
All right. There's a short sleeve sport coat, right?
Oh, my God. We didn't say that yesterday.
Lime green.
That was lime green.
Buy one, get one free.
Oh, yeah.
They really want to see. They give you the
free.
Free.
Yeah. Do free,
yeah.
Oh, I'm glad my hair is not getting messed up.
What hair? 1, 2,
and 3.
I'm looking down, that's good.
I was blinking, so.
Yeah, there we go, okay.
1, 2, and 3.
Do people usually cooperate this much?
No.
1, 2, and 3.
Thank you. the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We gather as God's people to celebrate His love, and on behalf of Amber and Felix and their families, it's a joy to welcome all of you to this celebration of the Eucharist and celebration of their marriage. As God's people celebrating His love, may we first ask His pardon for our failures to love one another as He has loved us. You were sent to heal the contrite, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for His church. Hear our prayers for Felix and Amber. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Sirach. Happy be the husband of a good wife, twice lengthened his days. A worthy wife brings joy to her husband, peaceful and full is his life. A good wife is a generous gift, bestowed upon him who fears the Lord. Be he rich or poor, his heart is content, and a smile is ever on his face. A gracious wife delights her husband. Her thoughtfulness puts flesh on his bones. A gift from the Lord is her guard of speech, and her firm virtue is of surpassing worth. Choicest of blessings is a modest wife, priceless her chaste person. Like the sun rising in the Lord's heavens, the beauty of a virtuous wife is the radiance of her home. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. reading from Ephesians. Follow the way of love, even as Christ loved you. He gave himself for you. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church. He gave himself up for her to make her holy. Purify her in the bath of water by the power of the word, to present himself a glorified church, holy and immaculate, without stain or wrinkle or anything of that sort. Husbands should love their wives as they do their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. Observe that no one hates his own flesh. No, he nourishes it and takes care of it as Christ cares for the church, for we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall cling to his wife, and the two shall be made into one. This is a great foreshadowing. I mean that it refers to Christ and the church. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Many different shapes and forms in our lives,
particularly today, we celebrate with Felix and Amber the marriage that they begin as a sign of that eternal divine love that is in just a moment to be theirs. That sacrament, that union of husband and wife, is a proclamation constantly to them and through them to all of us of the continuing love that God has for us, his people. And he says, enjoy it, live it to the full, realize what a privilege it is to be a sign of God's love in this sacrament of marriage. And so, Amber and Felix, we join with you in rejoicing and praising God today as we pray with you and for you that each day of your married life will be a continuing reflection of God's eternal love for you and through you for all of us. And as we experience and witness this sacrament this afternoon, may all of us be once again enriched by the presence of God calling us to be his people, and may we love one another always as the Lord has loved us and continues to love us through this sacrament, which is ours, our privilege now to witness. And so in that spirit, Felix and Amber, may I invite you to stand before the church and pronounce your marriage vows. Felix and Amber, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and of this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Felix and Amber, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
Will you love each other and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
We will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
We will.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your hands and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Felix.
Take you, Amber.
To be my wife. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you. All the days of my life. I, Amber.
Take you, Felix.
To be my husband. I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life. Felix and Amber, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, men must not divide.
May the Lord bless these rings which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. Amber, take this ring.
Amber, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Felix, take this ring.
Felix, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Please stand. Now that we have heard God's word in the Bible and felt his presence in the exchange of vows, let us present to God the Father these petitions for people in the world today. For our Holy Father on earth, the Pope and all the bishops and clergy everywhere, that they may lead us to a deeper faith in God and a stronger love for others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married persons, that they may continue to give, be able to forgive, and find happiness deepened with the passing of each day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Felix and Amber, now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love reaching out to others, and good health until ripe old age, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, lonely, discouraged, or oppressed, that they may be strengthened by God's help, and aided by their friends, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Felix and Amber, and of all present for this wedding, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For these personal needs which we now mention in silence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, your Son taught us to ask, to seek, and to knock. We have just done so, confident that you will now look upon our many needs. Consider our trusting faith, and in your great love, grant these requests which we present through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
I love you.
My sisters and brothers, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifices and your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his church.
Please stand. Lord, hear our prayers and accept the gifts we offer for Felix and Amber. Today you have made them one in the sacrament of marriage. May the mystery of Christ's unselfish love, which we celebrate in his Eucharist, increase their love for you and for each other. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
also with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. You created man in love to share your divine life. We see our high destiny in the love of husband and wife, which bears the imprint of your own divine love. Love is our origin. Love is our constant calling. Love is our fulfillment in heaven. The love of man and woman is made holy in the sacrament of marriage and becomes the mirror of your everlasting love. Through Christ, the choirs of angels and all the saints praise and worship your glory. May our voices blend with theirs as we join in their unending hymn. We offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, this saving cup,
We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in your body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with John Paul, our Pope, Roger, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
Thank you.
Lord, in your love, you have given us this Eucharist to unite us with one another and with you. As you have made Felix and Amber one in the sacrament of marriage, and in the sharing of one bread and one cup, so now make them one in love for each other. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
first. You know,
like, because if I were you, like, when he's reading the house, I would have been all just listening to this one. And then it would have been my turn, I would have been all.
He's all over the dress.
I know. Mrs. Masci.
Oh, Mrs. Masci.
Couple of Mrs. Masci.
Now there's more of us.
They're growing. They're spreading.
Well,
good. Break down. Pretty much it's what, give us a few more years, that's what's going to happen.
I was pretty nervous.
So what did you think of the ceremony?
I loved it. I was into it.
Yeah.
It was good. Very emotional.
We were very there. Pretty.
Yeah, we did.
One more little kiss?
Sure.
All right. I'll see you at the reception.
Okay.
our bride and groom is here, so anybody in the wedding party, parents, any groomsmen, bridesmaids, please go on out to the main lobby there where you came in. So anybody in the wedding party, parents, bridesmaids, groomsmen, please head on out there to the main lobby. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, may your attention please. Good afternoon. How's everybody doing today? Wait a minute. One more time. How's everybody doing today? Come on, let's hear you. That's what I want to hear. On behalf of the Radisson Hotel, Simi Valley, and Party Tree Mobile Dancers, bid you welcome to a wonderful day for a wonderful wedding. How was the wedding? Was it good or what? Beautiful? All right. Well, right now I want to introduce those good-looking people you saw earlier participating in that wedding party. They're going to be coming through those side doors. When I introduce them, I want you to give them a big, big round of applause because they deserve it. There's a lot of time, a lot of effort going to a day like today. So they deserve all the clapping and applause they deserve, okay? Eyes focus on those doors on the left, your right, Ed, if you please. The put your hands together right now. Come on, don't clap. Yes, give a nice hand one more time, come on. Ladies, you may be seated at this time. At this time, we would like to have the first dance with the bride and groom. They have chosen from Cristofori's Dream. Give a nice hand, okay? Let's give him a nice hand, folks. Yes, both of you, well done. Amber's there right there. Felix, you may step off at this time. Mr. Conroy, would you please come up and join your daughter at this time? Give him a nice hand, folks. For the father and daughter, and mother and son, they have their chosen butterfly kisses.
Two things I know for sure.
Give a nice hand, folks. Yes. Happy moment there. You may be seated at this time. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce myself. So that will be served in momentarily here. My name is Dave. I'm your MC for this evening, this afternoon. My DJ on my right, your left, is Ed. Everybody say hi to Ed. Over. Say hi, Ed.
Hi, Ed. That's all I ever get around here is hi, Ed. Anyways, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We've got all kinds of music for you tonight. Please come on up. If a certain song you want to hear, come on up. We do take requests. Basically, the bridegroom has asked that everybody has a great time tonight. They don't want to go out, go away without dancing. So everybody has a good time tonight.
All right. Now, Amber and Felix gave me a list of songs they like to listen to and play the dance to tonight. But also, I want to get a feeling from you folks what type of music people like to dance to and listen to, okay? So I'm going through the eras and the categories of music. Give me a round of applause. How many of you like the 40s, Glenn Miller, Tommy Dorsey, and Jerry Brown? All right. We'll see if you can outbeat, which I think you guys can, the young crowd. How about the 50s? Elvis Presley, Jerry Lee Lewis, the Everly Brothers. You know that? How about the 60s? The Beatles, the Beach Boys. You know that? Ed, I'll give you this one.
All right, any polyester retro people out there? All the disco fans?
There it is. That guy in the polyester shirt, did you do get a John Travolta and Saturday Night Fever, I think, without the goatee either? Yeah. We got that for you.
Your attention, please, for one more moment. What we're going to do today, normally at most weddings, you hear everybody clanging the glasses to get the bride and groom to kiss. It's a form of conditioning, so you go home, you clang on glasses, they'll kiss for you. Anyways, what we're going to try to do today, if you can think of any kind of song with love in it, what you have to do at your table, the whole table, just get up and shout it out. Anything with love in it, and then the bride and groom will kiss for you, okay? So any song that you know that has the word love, all of you guys at your table, stand up, sing it. We'll bring the music down, and they'll kiss for you.
Love is in many splendid things. You guys got to kiss. Now you, her, yeah, both. Yes. Lady Love, Lady Love, you gotta kiss again. Lady Love, Blue Rolls. You have to sing it though too. Where are you? If you say it, you must sing it. Yes, sir.
If I love you.
Sing it.
If I love you.
That's good enough. Kiss.
He's hired. Get him a job.
Who else is gonna sing? You gotta sing. So remember, if you say it, you gotta sing it too. Oh, back there. Back there, guys. Sing it, guys. You gotta sing it. Come on. When the moon hits the sky like a big pizza pie, that's what? You guys, kiss again, guys. That, you're Italian. Yeah, that was a big one for Italian. Wow. Anybody else? Sing it, ladies.
Oh yeah.
Give a nice hand. The bigger the song, the longer the lyrics, the longer the kiss. At this time, we'd like to do the toast. If everybody take their champagne glasses in front of them at this time, and please rise. And have your eyes focused on the head table up here. And at this time, Joey, the maid of honor, will start it off. Oh, no. Dave's going to do it. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. My name's David Masci. I am Felix's younger brother. And I have the privilege of being his best man. On behalf of the Masci family, Amber, I'd like to welcome you to our family. For those of you who have not gotten to know Amber yet, let me tell you how much of a pleasure it has been for me to have her being a part of my life and our family's life. Felix and Amber met about 4 years ago while they were involved in a young adult group at our parish. And since that time, I have witnessed and watched them grow together throughout the last few years. Amber has brought the best out of Felix. She has encouraged him and supported him, and I really see a happiness now in my brother's face that I have never seen before. I am always impressed with Amber's openness and her genuine love and concern for those individuals around her. And I would like to welcome Amber into our family, and I would like to thank Felix for having her. I'd like to have Joy read sentiments to Felix.
Well, David took the words out of my mouth, so can I just sit down and okay. Felix, you saw me cry last night, so I'm going to try not to do that now. But I was saying last night how important family is, and Felix has brought great importance of family back into the Conroy life and has only strengthened the Masci's family. And as Amber and Felix join together in marriage today, all of us sit in this room and think of our hearts as they get stronger and all of our bonds grow stronger just because of them. So thank you, Amber and Felix. We love you. And we have yet a few sayings for you both to remember.
We've got four toasts that we'd like to share. Hold your glasses until the very end. Amber and Felix, as you both change through the years, may the bond of love between you grow stronger.
May your commitment and dedication to each other be an example to our families.
May you be blessed with the gift of many children.
Keyword many.
And the patience to love them.
And may the Lord may always be part of the love you share.
To Felix and Amber.
Don't sit down yet, we have a few more toasts here. At this time, Mr. Masci, could you please come up here on the dance floor? And Mr. Conroy, could I have you come up here on the dance floor next to Mr. Masci, please?
The toast I have is a story. It goes back a long, long time. As a matter of fact, about 28 years. Barbara and I had two boys before she got pregnant again. And I said to her, I said, Barbara, the next one is going to be named Annette Marie. It's either going to be Annette Marie or it's going to be Felix. And that's my son, Felix. But he brought into this family the girl. And I don't say that in the sense that we don't have two daughter-in-laws before, but Felix was to be the girl. And I love you, Amber. You are part of our family. Thank you, Felix.
My story only goes back 26 years. So when Amber was born, Amber is our firstborn, and what a thrill it is to have a child, and how one thinks that the future lies gaping before you as a chasm and that you'll never get there. And I am stunned and shocked to stand here today and see here a young woman, and to see her sisters and her brother, young women and a young man. And I am proud of her, and I'm proud of Felix. I want to tell all of you who are my guests especially that I'm very, very happy that you're here, that you're all very dear to me, and thank you for being here. I want to say to the Masci family and all of their guests how glad I am that Amber is now a Masci. How proud I am. How pleased I was today to walk her down the aisle and put her into Felix's hands and into Felix's arms. I want to say congratulations, and I want to say cheers.
All right. Last but not least, and more important, Felix himself.
It's not usually tradition for the groom to make a toast, I know, but anyway.
said it's normally not tradition for the groom to make a toast, but I'm going to make one anyway. I want to thank, first of all, my bride, because she has been a tremendous influence on my life since I've met her. She, as I said, have really brought out the best part of me. So first toast goes to Amber. I do love you very much. You're a wonderful girl. Secondly, I want to thank all of you people, because doing this alone doesn't work. I can't celebrate alone. I'm not used to celebrating. This is pretty much my first party I've ever thrown, so. All of you have at some point influenced my life or her life, been somewhere involved, so that all comes back into the relationship. So I want to thank all of you for being here, supporting us, and being part of our relationship. That really makes a difference. It's really a wonderful part of life. And most importantly, I want to thank the parents. I want to thank my dad for being very patient and understanding as we do this whole wedding. My mother for all the little things she did for us selflessly. For Brian for his wit and his understanding and input. And most of all for Heather for having Amber. Because without that, I don't have a whole lot to celebrate today. To the parents.
I just want to tell everyone thank you very, very much. I'm a little bit overwhelmed and certainly happy that you're here to celebrate with me. And Felix is God's greatest gift to me, and thank you all who are here who helped form him and mold him and support him. And thank you to everyone here who helped do the same for me.
Let's give everybody a nice big hand for all those. Yes. A lot of love in here tonight. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, this time your dinner is now coming out, so get ready to have a good time with it.
Felix and Amber, this is Aunt Rita and Uncle Ray, and we give you our very, very best. And I'll tell you the same thing that Uncle Ray said last night that Grandpa Nealon told us when we got married. We wish you...
May all your troubles be little ones.
And may all your enemies die of loathsome disease.
And we'll also extend the invitation again to spend your second honeymoon with us in Georgia.
Please, we love you very,
God bless
very
you.
Much.
Hi, Felix and Amber. This videographer got me after two glasses of wine. But I do want to wish you all the love and happiness with God in your hearts forever. That's all I have to say.
Amber, Felix, congratulations. All right.
I'm not very good at this, sorry.
Excellent. Amber. I remember when I met you in organic chemistry class, and it was really uneventful. But then I was in your class, in your herpetology class, and that's where it all began. And I was very excited when you told me about Felix and how, well, at the beginning it wasn't like, you were really weren't sure where it was going to lead to, but it was to a very successful place. Thank you.
Well, Angela, that was an abrupt ending.
Thank you. Okay.
Hi, Amber and Felix. Amber, although you told the story of me kissing the little flower on my training bra about 1,000 times to people I didn't want know about it, I'm still going to wish you the very best. How gracious of me. At any rate, I love you both very much, and as I've said about a billion times, you're an inspiration to us all, and just that we love you, and thank you for having me a part of this. It's very precious to me, and it's an honor. So I hope you have a great time in Maui, and we'll see you when you get back.
Hi, Amber. I wanted to thank you for asking me to be a part of this. I've been really honored. I've been looking forward to this for a long time. And seeing you and Felix together has made me realize I shouldn't settle for less. Be strong, woman. And we're done.
That about wraps
thank
it up.
You. Well, we love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, view in next
yes,
time.
Amber and Felix, we're having a blast. And we wanted to, no, I don't think so. I'm getting mic instructions from the best man here. Just wanted to say thanks for having us be part of this incredible celebration. We're thoroughly amazed at your grace and your beauty and your poise. And for your first party, wow, what a hellacious party. Congratulations to you both. We love you. Take care.
Whoa, whoa, hey, yeah. Love you, babe. Mean it. All right, who's the bride and groom here? Shush, shush. All right, anyway, Amber and Felix, I would like to tell you both that I'm having a fantastic time as well. Who knew? And it's actually really a pleasant surprise here to see everybody that I haven't seen in quite some time. But then again, I'm also excited about your marriage thing, too. That's also pretty exciting. I'm probably just almost as excited and happy for you guys as you are for yourselves. This has been quite an awe-inspiring day for me. It was just amazing for me to watch you both marry each other, and I couldn't really believe it, but it's already happened, so I guess I have to get used to it. I love you both very much. I'm proud to be now somehow technically joined with the Masci family as well, and I really wish you both just the best, because you guys are really good to each other, and you guys are going to be happy. Oh, and hundreds of kids, I guess. Is that the running joke for the evening? And now, over to Mike. Mike?
Hey.
No, that's the mic.
Mike. I'm Mike. Right. But this is a mic, too. But alrighty. Loving an elevator. Living it up while I'm going down.
Yeah, babe. Whoa.
Anyway, hi, Amber and Felix. Thank you very much for allowing me to be a part of this special day. I remember the time, like I said, when Amber was looking for someone, didn't know where to find them, was very desperately looking, and Angela was just saying, do I know anybody? And I was like, I don't know anybody.
And, you know, the list
and no, it wasn't. I'm glad to know that Amber actually... you were able to find Felix, and I know that both of you are going to have a splendid life together. And I know that you've had some ups and downs, but we've all had ups and downs, and you know that. You know about me and Angela. So I'm glad to be able to share our lives together and be able to be friends and be able to just take off the masks and say, you know, the way that things are.
Thank you for putting it back on.
I don't know if you heard that one, but anyway, <Yeah. laughs> I pray that you guys will be able to allow Christ to be the center of your marriage, and that Felix, you will love Amber as Christ loves the church. If you do that, she'll never have any complaints. I mean, wow, what a tall order. On the other hand, Amber, you're supposed to be submissive onto Felix now, and in this day and age, that's really a hard thing to do.
Yes, you might want to skip that one.
You may want to skip that one,
sure.
Right? Like cross out of the verse.
Sure,
let me like, that verse right. Doesn't exist, right,
yeah,
or something?
Kind of take that out of the contract.
You know, I mean,
sure.
My wife seems to be able to do that quite easily.
Oh, no. Yeah, she writes
you know,
that one
she
off.
She just says, you know, but she's very good though. She'll say
oh, yeah.
If there's anything that we really have to. She's very good there. But okay,
it's a good thing
anyway.
You can edit this.
It is a good thing you can edit this, isn't it?
Yes.
But anyway, I do hope that you do have a beautiful wedding, and you've already had a beautiful marriage day today, and that your marriage will be fantastic, and you'll be loaded with lots of children that you want.
Yeah, once again, the
wonderful
theme,
children.
About 20,
thing?
20 kids or so.
Oh, it's 20 kids?
Yeah, I think that's
all right. Anyway,
now.
I think I've said enough. Joe, would you like to say something?
Oh, yes, I think I shall.
Okay.
For you.
Felix and Amber, it's amazing to see the two of you up there today, to see how so much can be built when two people work together on it. Life is going to be very interesting for you, and I wish that God would bless you in every way possible. And by the way, you look marvelous.
Yes, I do look marvelous.
Lovely, gorgeous.
I don't know, brother, Amber, sister, you guys have meant so much to me. You know how much I have struggled through relationships and school and career decisions, and you have been there for me, tried and true, in the bar and school and the bar. And you guys have really been for me, tried and true, and I really want to thank you guys for that. You have been extremely special to me. And I know that is only going to continue as time passes. You are a blessing in my life. Amber, specifically, I feel so comfortable with you. You know all my secrets, and you know all about me, and you still love me besides that, and I appreciate that. On behalf of all the groomsmen here, I just want to say we love you, and I think we're all very happy to be part of your wedding. And Godspeed and God bless to both of you.
And remember, I still hold the record on kids right now. Okay, I set the standard.
Yeah, you have just a few years.
I think he's gonna hold the record. Period. So, thank you.
Come up here, Felix, with your lovely bride, the center of the dance floor. There he is. Lost him already. All right. When we talked last week, we always tell the bride and groom, you know, we should do a group dance, which is concerns everybody involved. And a certain song concerns everybody involved. So this is a group dance we normally do earlier, but we wanted to do it this time here. And it's Natalie Cole and Matt King Cole's Unforgettable, because it's going to be an unforgettable night with the bride and groom and all you folks out there, too. So join your partners this time with the sound of Unforgettable, okay? And can we dim the lights down a little bit, too, please? A little atmospheric mood.
Thank you.
Just remember, you guys are unforgettable. Anyways, we're going to help you out with one more song about love called Love Shack.
We got more from the action. Well, Amber and Felix, we just want to say congratulations and best wishes. And knowing you for such a long time, since 1983, I believe, we moved on the block, there are probably some things we know that you probably don't want us to tell Felix. But let me just turn it over to Stacy for a minute.
Julie, you want to say something?
We both say something together. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Congratulations, Amber and Felix.
Have a happy life.
Gentlemen, we have a special treat for you tonight. Ron, the video guy, can I have your attention, please? Ron.
Where are you?
Ron, I'm over here, Ron. Folks, can I have you step back just over here for 1 second, please? You got this thing on?
Yeah.
I want to focus on right over there next to my DJ on the other side of those doors. Ladies and gentlemen, straight from San Francisco, I want you to give a big round of applause and also go along with them because they're great fun. The Village People! Yeah. Thanks, my friend. Right, come on.
You guys can help them out with the YMCA. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Action.
Let's see it. Come on, everybody. Let's hear it one more time.
YMCA. It's for the spirit.
YMCA. One more time. Have a nice hand of village people! You guys are great. We're gonna stay with Sevens for one more song here. A little request, I Will Survive. And I hope so after this number.
Hi, Amber, we love you. Happy congratulations.
Yes. Okay, your turn.
Happy wedding, Amber.
Here's the mother.
I love Amber and I love Felix. He is like my son and my daughter and they're wonderful.
Are you an actress or what? I tell you. Good luck, Amber and Felix. Have a nice life.
Congratulations, Felix. Amber, we love you both. Amber is forever. Good luck forever. We love you.
Okay, Amber and Felix, we wish you many, many years of happiness. We love your folks and maybe say something.
That's about it. Thank you. My name is Bob and Carol Cacabo. Thank you.
Amber, I hope you're taking good care of that special guy. Many years of happiness, much joy, lots of love. This is Nancy Grasmer. Enjoy.
Over to the cake cutting in the corner there. Ron and Curtis. And of course, the bride and groom, Felix and Amber, where are you? We need you over here in the corner of the cake. After that, we have got the bouquet and garter and the money dance, so stay tuned.
Toast the video camera.
Yeah, babe. Yeah, babe.
And kiss.
Oh, please don't do that.
You guys like all these eyes focusing on you?
It's not real.
It's a fake kiss.
That's not a real
knife. Yeah. Oh, it's my finger.
Go ahead and cut a piece out.
Wow, that's a good piece.
Bullet.
This is a new piece right here?
There's a little spatula right next to it.
Wow, this is a pretty good size piece
of cake.
All right, cut it in half. Now, are you going first, Amber, or are you guys going at the same time?
Same time.
Put the knife down.
All right, wait on my call, and you guys are ready to beat each other.
Yeah.
Go.
Be nice. You guys murdered. Everybody, count for your winner. One, two, three. Single ladies
on the floor. Anyone wanting to be single today?
Surprise, we're a little single. Come on up, those girls. These young ladies are very young, especially this one is not married.
Here's Miss Janet. You're right up here, young lady.
Anybody else? Anybody back there? Who's moving single? Megan Noonan. Noonan? Megan? Where's Megan? Is Megan up here? No? All right, ladies, nice and close together. We get you all in the picture also. Put the little ones in front. It's only fair. Okay. Any more single people? Hurry up now. It's your chance. Okay, we all ready. Ron, you all set? Curtis is all set. Amber, you all set? Ladies, you better be married. Yes. Everybody count to three with me. Here we go. One, two. Wait, hold it. What? Oh, where have you been all night? Shame on you. All right, here we go. One more time. One, two, three. You guys are ready. This one's for real. Here we go. One, two, two and a half, three. Who's the winner? Catch it. The one that came in late is the winner. Give her a nice hand. And what is your name, young lady?
Megan.
Oh, yeah, that's what we called earlier for you. Okay, Megan, congratulations. Just step up because later on we get a pitch with you and the bride in the groom and the other gentleman kisses the garter. All right. Felix, come on up. Amber, stay right there. Right here first, good. See you guys right behind her. Amber, let's see. There you go. Guys, get right behind her. Nice and close. Nice and close. Single guys, anybody else? Any more single guys over here? Who? Where's your dad? Dad over there, come on up. This gentleman's single?
Come on up, sure.
How about this guy? You won't go? Oh, you're missing out on a good deal. All right, anybody over here? Single guys over here in the back.
All right, I'll tell you, same rule applies. If you want to be single today, now's your chance. We'll go in this wedding. Come on up on the floor.
Who? Dad, Mr. Conroy, where are you? Where'd he go? There he is. Come on, Dad. Yeah, we want you. Request your daughter and son-in-law. Yeah, right up there behind your daughter. Gentlemen, too, great. Come right up there, sir. Come right next to your daughter.
Aria, bring the music down. All right, first thing I need is a huddle. Hold it, don't start yet. Remember what I told you last week? Wait. You guys huddle in over here. All right, Anna, you ready?
I'm ready.
Do it. Sing it, guys, come on. Nice and loud, come on.
And there's no tenderness but grief for in your fingertips.
Nice and loud, come on, she loves it.
You're trying hard enough.
Everybody with me.
Baby,
one more time.
Baby, I know.
Everybody sing.
You want that love and feeling.
One more time.
Oh, that love and feeling.
Go for threes.
You lost that love and feeling. Now it's gone, gone, gone.
All right, sing this part. Ready? Yeah, you guys are great. Give a nice hand. All right, Ed, you ready for the next one? You know which one, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Felix. Felix, come right over here. Come over here. No. Dad's watching. You may be married to her, but she's still his little girl, so watch out. You take it nice and slow. Don't rush it. Take your time, all right? Go to the beat of the music. Ed, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Play it. Bring it up. Whistle, guys. Step off, and if somebody could just move that chair off to one side. Guys, step back. Felix, get in position where your wife was. And whoever catches the guard, please do not take off. We need a picture with you and a young lady caught the bouquet with the bride and groom. Felix, you all set?
Yeah.
Let's go for it, guys. Everybody, count to three with me. One, two, three. Who's the winner? Who won? Who's this guy right here? This guy right here. This guy, right here. What's his name? Chris Hopkins, congratulations. Get you a picture with you guys. All right, guys, you may step off. Get a picture with Curtis, the bride and groom, the young lady called the bouquet. All right.
3, 2, 1. Thank you.
Amber and Felix. We love
Joe
you. They're doing a Joe and Mary anniversary celebration right now. We can't wait and we celebrate your anniversary. Proud of you. We're glad to be with you. You showed us how to do it right and we love you.
I think you guys are perfect for each other and I'm so happy with both of you. I know you'll be happy forever.
God bless you.
Well, Felix, good luck.
I think it can be summed up with just Brekka. Pretty much says it all.
We're right behind you.
Amber and Felix, I have only one thing to say to you, and that is bless.
Hi, Amber and Felix. Congratulations, you guys. You're the best couple, and I hope you have a really good time on your honeymoon. Woo!
Amber and Felix, you know how much we love you. I want to see them. you know how much we love you. I've said it before, and I can say it again, but it's the same story. We love you very much. Amber, you're just so sweet. And I keep looking at you and not the camera because you're at the front table. But I have to see you when I'm talking to you. And I just hope you have a nice, a wonderful vacation. And we'll see you when you get back. And I will have a nice present for you, too.
Okay. Felix and Amber, all I can do is give you all my love. I am so happy to have the two of you together. And I'll do your wash almost any time. I love you both very much. The best of luck.
Good evening and welcome. Tomorrow it's going to be sunny and hot, so enjoy yourselves. Santa Ana wind's going to be blowing out of the north. Now, if you have any free time, try to get down to San Diego tomorrow. It's going to be a regatta, so enjoy yourselves and have a nice day. Thank you.
Thank you. sun and all its glory. This is there with hope and comfort. And you're from my life, from my world. You can make it now. Here's my troubles, that's what you need.
Anything can happen.
that, you will be very careful. Because there's nobody else up here, so you're stuck with these guys. Help me get some 20s. Any more guys visiting girls for Felix? Any more girls for Felix here? Hi, Joanna.
Any more contestants?
Yeah, we got a couple more here.
Oh yeah, I wanna know, 'cause you from
Who do we want to thank? First of all, from way far away, everybody in England who sent a wonderful card, we want to thank you, and Uncle Michael for being the ambassador from the UK. I want to thank all my relatives from coming out back east, Aunt Rose, Uncle Bob, Aunt Rita, Uncle Ray. That was the crew, basically. We want to thank the parents, of course. They've supported us through the whole thing. The Conroys and the Massies. I want to thank my family for coming out. Chris and Karen from Colorado with their two kids. And Joe and Mary for bringing the whole clan along. And David for being an excellent, wonderful...
Wonderful best man.
Wonderful best man.
And to all our wedding party, you're very, very special to us, all of you. And you know how special you are. I know you do. And we hope to have lots of loving, lasting memories with all of you in our future. And thank you to Felix, who's been flexible and loving and the best. I couldn't ask for a better husband. I couldn't.
also want to thank Joy for being an excellent bridesmaid.
Good Joy.
And pampering my Amber.
Thank you.
And I want to thank Amber for being the love of my life. She's been wonderful and helped me get through today very differently than it would have been. She's an excellent compliment to me. And I want to thank everybody who came. We had a great time. It sounded like everybody else did too. And everybody helped make it a party. And this is wonderful because we wanted to celebrate our union.
Yes, this is a celebration, and we're very happy. Love you.
I love you, sweetheart.